Okay, so you've probably got two questions. One is why has this channel become so sporadic? And the second, how long before it goes back to what it used to be? Well, typical for me, I'm going to answer the second question first. I guess about 6 to 8 weeks. And that's because of the first question. As you probably know, if you've been following this channel, I've been looking for another job. I'm happy to announce that I've been successful in another position. A few people know where that is, but I just don't want to put it out on a totally unfettered public channel as of yet, because I still don't know very much about where I'm walking into until my first day there. If you know what I mean. I passed all the checks and I've served my notice with my current employer, so I'm going through that period before then, in a few weeks' time, I start the new position. So, as you can probably work out, this is quite an emotional time for me, and that's made it difficult to record these videos in anything like the frequency that I have been. So that's why this channel has become quite sporadic. There's been a few extra bits and pieces on top of that, but that's the main one. So what's been going on here? Quite a few bits and pieces. I managed to blow up a board. This is the USB board for the Mister. It is now a dead board because I overvolted it. I'm absolutely amazed that I didn't do more damage, and to be perfectly honest, it just blew the USB expansion board. The FPGA system itself and the top I/O board were perfectly fine. So I went to where I bought the Mister from in the first place, explained, and the guy was extremely helpful. So I got a second board. It's all assembled now. I also took the opportunity to upgrade the fan to a Noctua fan and upgrade the RAM while I was at it. So that's all with me. The Mister is now reassembled and it's working fine. Good news on that. And now I know I'm not the first person to do this, and now I've actually put some labels on the ends of the plugs so I know green is for 5 volts, red is for 12 volts, and using that code I should know roughly what I'm doing. And if it hasn't got a color code, it's something strange and I should definitely be looking at the plug to see what it's doing. So yeah, that was a bit of drama, unnecessary expense. My fault. Totally my fault. Another reason for not making videos is this place has been an absolute, well, an absolute shithole, to be honest. And that's because I had to rerun some cables. It all started with a friend of mine who was getting rid of some equipment. Among the equipment that she was getting rid of was this. Now I use these. This is a KVM and this is a DVI KVM. She'd bought the wrong one. She needed a DisplayPort because, yeah, there's a restriction on DVI. If you only have, and a lot of people use DVI and they only use cables which are about as thick as my little finger, if anything a bit narrower. And what those are is they are single lane DVI. They're only capable of 1080p. If you want to go further, you've got to use dual lane DVI, and those cables are quite a bit thicker. They're thicker than my thumb. Maybe roughly thereabouts. So I got my hands on this, and I thought, you know what, in order to do this, the cables are pretty thick. So out with the drill, start drilling holes bigger than they were, because I needed them, and five of those cables, ouch. So I had to pull the PCs to pieces anyway, and then I determined, you know what, this is insane. These cables are way too thick. Not only that, my Avimedia recorder, it's HDMI, and I'm only recording in 1080p anyway. So what the hell? So I decided to get a load of these, which are HDMI to DVI converters. Put these, you'll notice that those have got the pins for dual link, although I think that they will only go to 1080, I don't know. So I got a load of those and put those in, and I've got HDMI cables running to the PCs now, which are going through those on the back of one of those. But in the meantime, in order to do that, one of the PCs down here was out, because there's four machines around here. So I had to pull that out, and one of the machines has got a couple of problems. One, the network cable that I'd routed, the plastic bit had snapped off, which they sometimes do. But not only that, the previous optical audio link, the cable had managed to, you know, it had managed to get so hot that the plastic in the socket and the plug had managed to weld themselves together. So I had a heck of a job trying to unplug that cable. And the cable broke. New cable, but of course there's bits still in there, so it won't fully go in. So between the two of them, I thought, okay. Every time I actually sort of sorted them out and pushed the whole thing back in, one of them would fail. Either the network would be slightly out, or the optical connection would be slightly out and I'd get no audio. One of the two. I thought, stuff this. It's about time that I replaced the cables. So I thought, okay, let's do that. And I got myself, I thought, what is it, a 5 meter run? So if I get myself some 7 meter Cat 6 cables, I'll be fine. So I got some of these, and I'm happily wiring it out. But of course, in order to do that, everything is behind all these. So everything had to come out in order for me to get behind to do the cables. And I get all the way to be behind me here, and then I run out of cable. I thought, what? Then I worked out that it's actually an 8 meter run, not 5, and I now need 10 meter cables. So after tearing the original cables out, putting the 7 meters in, I then have to tear the 7 meters out, order 10 meters, and this place is an entire crap hole for quite a few days before the 10 meters arrive, and then I've got to put all those in. So this place has been an absolute shithole for about a week, and yeah, definitely not conducive to doing anything, let alone making videos. But now everything's pretty much wired in. I've managed to MacGyver a way of keeping the optical cable in. And that is by, you know, you've got the cable and you've got the plug itself, and then you've got the cable coming off. And by using some cable ties around there and anchoring that to the case. I didn't want to put any blue tack in, because that would increase the heat and do the same again. So, oh God, how I MacGyvered that, you do not want to know. I don't want to know. But it works, and that's all that counts. Another thing that ended up with a mister, why I ended up with a mister and trying to plug it in and run the damn thing in the first place, was for joysticks. Now, a chunk of this is not going to make sense giving it to you now. It's only when you work it over quite a few weeks that this all took. I knew that I wanted to relax. I knew I wanted to make more of the mister. So I needed a better joystick. The usual sort of Xbox, PlayStation kind of controller doesn't really do it for me. So I talked with a few people. And I ended up with the bright idea of having two joysticks. One with quality parts, and then another one with good parts, but you know, you can play Hypersports. And it doesn't matter if you kill the damn thing. That was the idea. And it wound up in a sort of a bit of a mess. And I ended up taking a punt. Now, there's pretty much three ways of getting a case. A lot of people, and I've seen them do various things, is make a joystick case themselves. I did it myself with the BBC joysticks quite a few years ago. Didn't really want to do that because trying to find a decent project case is not the easiest thing. And I don't have the tools or the space here to start messing around with wood as some other people have done. So that option was sort of off the table. That left two other options. One of which was a pre-made pad, and there are some others going around as well. So I took a chance. This was going relatively cheap, and this is a Venom V something or other. Now, these are not the original buttons or the original stick, and it's built for the Sony PlayStation 3 and 4. I think it was going for about 30 odd pounds, but for the case itself and what it is, I thought, okay, I'll take a punt on this. It turns out that the controller does actually work with the mister. Now, the original buttons that came on this were just some squishy crap, and the joystick was, yeah. So the joystick has been replaced with a soundbar with an Octagate on it, and the buttons have been replaced with decent buttons. I wanted to keep them flush, but I couldn't because of the distance between the buttons and the case. The depth, as you can probably see, is quite is pushing it. So yeah, I don't know if I can easily show you that clearly, but yeah, with a button on the top there, the micro switch at the bottom comes perilously close to the base. So I had to raise everything, and the spades didn't work. The spades are larger than the ones that came with the various bits and pieces. So I had to just use a solder job and solder all these in. Now, the interesting thing that I noted was you've got eight buttons here, one button there, and the few buttons here, which some of which are specialist, shall I say. Come on to that in a second. But the other thing that I noted was this. So I thought, okay, that for one of them, and then this for the hack and slash and bash. Now, the case itself, I was just going to use these cases. I think I had three potentially on order from China at any one time. This is the only one that made it. The other seller backed out, refused to send, and wanted me to pay. They doubled the cost of the units, basically. Now, there is an arcade place in the UK which sort of sells these, and they were in smoke. A nice smoke, so you could see some of the insides as well, so you could see some of the wiring, which appealed to me, but they've been out of stock and it doesn't look like they're getting any back in. So this one, you can see it under there, it's bog standard, it's nothing special. This one is Pac-Man, which I thought was great. And as you can see, there's a sandblast stick in there with an Octagate, which helps. I'm going to have to put in another couple of buttons here, at least one for... it's probably going to be a push button on the side for second player, because when you're programming up the arcade ROMs on the Mister and changing the controls, they ask, okay, what do you want to press for second player? I think I can skip it, I'm not sure, but hey ho. The interesting things in these is the holes. These were 28, I think, and these were 24, but all these buttons, I think, were actually a combination of 24 and 28. They're sort of, you can probably see it on one of these, is that they're not quite 28, and but they'll cover the hole, if you know what I mean. It's difficult, but they just about do it. But I thought, yeah, I'm up for that. Wasn't too expensive, and you obviously need a controller, which is where this comes in, which is a box of all sorts. And I'm just going to have to edit that out of the video, which is a bit of a mess. Now, I thought two sticks, I'm going to need two controllers the same. So I actually have got KTRL arcade default controllers from, where are they from? Initially, I got a Player X controller, and the reason I got this was because I thought, I know, I would get myself a nice, simple A4 thing like this, which is simply a document holder. Then I could drill some holes, mount the controllers, do the wiring, and then I could work out what I was doing before I ended up with controllers. And somehow I saw the controllers at the right price while all this slot was still sort of in the post anyway. And when these other controllers came on board, looking at these buttons, that button layout, you can pretty much see that it's more or less the same as the Sony PlayStation. So by changing the controller in that one, I'm not exactly going to benefit much, because some of those buttons are actually feature. They actually change the features of the buttons. 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. They've got 12 buttons plus the stick. And this one is 8, 9, 10, so it's sort of the same. One of them is a feature button, which is a configuration button. So you press the config button and then press some of the other buttons to change the configuration. Quite smart. The reason for two controllers the same was they will return the same codes to the Mister, so I can change the joysticks out and it doesn't matter. Here's the PlayStation ones. Absolutely bugger all behind there. I ended up with some others because I thought that was going to be the way to go. That's the original PlayStation logo. And yeah, it didn't work. So I got myself a load of decent arcade ones. Now, and I ended up trying to get a load of harnesses and other cables, because some of the buttons didn't come with cables, so trying to get the cables was another nightmare. And this is actually the old stick from inside the PlayStation unit, and that wiring was different. This has two wires to each micro switch, whereas the Sanwa has a 5-pin straight onto the side of the board. Fortunately, the controller in there was fine anyway. And I ended up with another controller purely because I wanted some of these cables. So yeah, I've ended up with quite a bit of parts. Trying to get the coin and one on two player was also a bit awkward. These, incidentally, are the ones that I used on the BBC Micro. joysticks. So yeah, that's been interesting. Blowing things up, fixing things, and experimenting. This is now working quite well. And I'm wondering whether I actually do need two separate joysticks. Whether it is going to get that kind of, that degree of hammer. And I don't know. We're going to have to see what happens. Is this... I thought this was strange. This is actually new. Because the covers are still on them. Well, that's going to be interesting. How am I going to get that off there? Because there must be... Yeah. There's also a covering on this one as well. I might actually have to take this apart and take the covering off the other one. Oh, that's going to be entertaining. Having to unscrew it all and then unscrew the buttons in order to get the plastic off. Yeah, that's very interesting. Or is it? Is that underneath? I don't know. Anyway, so there you go. It's been quite an interesting, time. One of the things that my friend was actually getting rid of was actually this, which is a Penix small keyboard, which is actually ideal for using the Mister. I'm going to have to clean it up. Shouldn't do that. It's plugged in. Unwind it again. And put it safely to one side. I actually brought out the Samsung tablet. That was an interesting thing. Because I needed something to play. And I've had this for quite a few years now, and the battery's still good on it. And I was playing Crayon Physics. Crayon Physics? I think it's Crayon Physics. But it's pretty good. not exactly the fastest of tablets, by any stretch of the imagination. Quite old now. I don't think it will update anymore. But it's got quite an interesting magnetic sort of distance pencil. And yeah, I've been playing Crayon Physics on that, which is quite a good game, quite a good puzzle game. Some of them, the levels would just blow my brains. And for some reason, trying to get hold of some of the walkthroughs is proven difficult as well. I think that brings us to the last thing, which is IdleCam. It's also, I have been trying to keep up with a few bits and pieces on YouTube. It's interesting to see Galacticus X back making videos. He's going through some plays. And he's recording them in I'm pretty sure he's recording them in Greek now. But hey ho. It's still good to watch him play through some of them. I think Defender was the last one. Anyway, the IdleCam. This was a project I backed years ago, and it finally came to fruition. And it's probably going to be next year before I use this in anger. The system itself is the whole system. Is on a gimbal. You can actually put it into selfie mode if you wish. And yeah, the lenses are interesting because they interchange. You can just unscrew and unmagnetize the lens, and so you can change lenses. I've only got two. When I can afford them, I'll go back for some more. Obviously, you can't use this in the foul weather. It ain't gonna happen. But it's an interesting piece of kit. It's, as most kit of its size, that starts up and says hello, and then you have to turn the gimbal on, and then the gimbal is active, and it does all sorts of quality. It's quite good quality. I'm not sure how long the battery lasts. It's got a reasonable microphone in. It comes with a microphone thing. You put that on top of it, and that acts as a wind shield for the microphone. It does have sockets for an external microphone, which is going to be very interesting for me. I've only got the two lenses. It's also got a lighting system. There's two lights that came with it. One is a beauty light. I'm just going to switch the gimbal off so I can put this on safely. And one of it is like that. And that's so they just clip on and use the battery, which is pretty impressive. It's very well designed. Came with two batteries. I also bought the optional selfie stick. I was impressed with the videos that were coming out of it. It's got various modes and there's only a few buttons. So with a lot of the complex features on this, you've got to know the particular section of buttons and stuff that you've got to press in order to make things happen and work. So yeah, it's got time-lapse modes and all the rest of it. There's extra sockets for memory card, video, HDMI I think. Yep, USB and auxiliary. So you can plug in an auxiliary microphone. So I'm looking forward to testing the microphones with this and hopefully getting the Rode microphones back up and running, because those don't work with the GoPros. The GoPro is a sensitive system. So the Rodes are just too loud for it. It just can't handle it. So hey ho. At some point I will start using that, and hopefully next year, once things are back in some sort of order, I hope, I should be back to vlogging as I used to, or more like I used to. Because COVID has really put a banjax on a lot of out and about for me. Obviously, living with mum, I've got to be careful with what I'm doing and all that good stuff. I have been playing games. I have been playing more of 7 Days to Die. Since I've had the Mister system back up and running, I've been playing Bomb Jack. That's one of my favourites. And I've been testing out the Octagate with a number of other games. I haven't tested them with any fighting games yet, which is where the Octagate really comes into its own. But it helps on a few other games like Pac-Man and those sorts of things. So I really don't know what's going to happen. A number of the things I wanted to get deliberately, because when you change employer in the UK, you end up going on to emergency tax, which is going to banjax me for a couple of months. Plus, we have our darling Brexit coming around the corner in a few months. I wanted to get as much as I can from overseas as I could, because we don't know what's going to happen. There's going to be no clue. It just made sense to get everything that I wanted to do done now before that lot hits, and that way I'm not in not having a problem. There's still a lot of tidying to do here. A shed load of tidying. As part of the having things out and about, I've come across a few things that I'm going to get rid of. Some tech that I'm going to strip down and throw out. Because some of the stuff seemed like a good idea at the time, wasn't really. So I've got to go through a few things. I've got a few PCs here. One that someone, a friend, bought, and it came to me to set up. And thanks to COVID, he's never been down for me to teach him how Linux works. And one is from the friend who was getting rid of some stuff, and I haven't even powered it on yet to see what's in it. I've been told there's no hard drive in it, but I don't know the spec. And I think I already know a new home for it. I've also been using using the CompuClean. Now these itdusters.com, I think. I've shown this before on this channel, but in case you haven't seen it, itdusters.com. You can probably see that if you freeze it somehow. The long story short is, when it comes to cleaning things, we tend to go through air dusters, and those are typically aerosols, and the propellant can get all over the place. This is expensive, but it just takes air in and it blows air out at quite a rate. And typically what I'll do is I'll switch off a machine. I did it with the main server, switch it off, leave it for about half an hour to an hour to cool down, and then unplug it, take it out the black, give it a good blast with this and a good clean out, and then let it settle again for another half an hour or so before plugging it in and firing it back up. And, you know, I think about £50 to £60 this costs. But it's been worth it for me. It's been worth it. Yeah, it's very difficult to wrap the cord on this thing. It's an absolute pain in the a. But, yeah. With the amount of systems that I clean, it is worth it. Just pick the fluff out of the filter. Yeah, I'll take care of that. I've still got to take the Hoover over here to Hoover up all the wood as a result of all the drilling. It's been pretty chaotic here the last few weeks. I was thinking of one of the live streams in order to catch up with the links that I've got. But to be honest, some of the news now is so old, it's ridiculous. I have a pipe wrench on the floor. I don't know why. I must have used it for something. Something was probably not playing ball. So yeah, there's still quite a bit of tidying up to do, but at least I've done the worst of it. I've replaced the cable. Yeah. That's the quick start guide for the idle cam. Where the hell did I put that? Over there. So, I've been keeping track of a few things. There's some stuff that I just... I can't keep track of everything. I can't keep tabs on everything. It's interesting to see Zarkos and the Archies. I've yet to sit down and watch all of them all the way through. But with what's happening around here, you can probably understand why I'm a bit behind on things. You know, it's gone 11 o'clock. I'm on earlies tomorrow. And I already went to bed once, but I knew that I wanted to record this video, so I thought, stuff it, and I got up, and here I am, explaining to you what's been going on. So yeah, thanks for your patience. Things are happening. It's going to take a while. But there is a light at the end of the tunnel. And things are moving for me. Things are progressing. And yeah. A new job awaits. So there is just so much to do. So much to do. I'll see you on the next one. Take care of yourselves. Until then, ciao for now.